Ooh, wow, she's really jumpy. Oh, man. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, okay, okay. This is not what I remember. Ow! She actually just nipped me, guys. You will not believe what happened. Do you guys remember Rocky the opossum? The little baby that we found after her mom got run over by a car, who at the beginning kind of hated us, but then learned to trust us. And it was kind of cool. We saw her grow a bit. She ended up eating a whole bunch of crickets in that one video. Well, she has returned. Back in July, she actually broke out of the habitat I had for her and escaped through the window. On her way out, also, I had some mice and she ended up eating those mice. But the thing is, I didn't see her ever since then, and I was kind of hoping she would survive, but I realized her chances were not the best because we live in a neighborhood with coyotes and bobcats, and even some mountain lions have been spotted. Just yesterday, I was going for a run and I saw an opossum and I was like, could that be Rocky? So I set a live trap. 2 hours later, bam, we get her. And sure enough, it's Rocky. I actually haven't taken her out of the trap yet. I gave her some time to relax. But as you can tell, she is pretty tense right now. She's showing us some teeth. I honestly don't know if she's remembered us. How I know it's her is she has the same coloring design on her tail. I honestly have no idea how she's gonna respond. What I'm gonna do is actually put on gloves, because she might freak out. I also don't know how long opossum memories are, and it's been literally almost 5 months since I've seen her. So back then she trusted me to an extent, and she would let me hold her and climb on me, and she would even fall asleep in my lap. But that was 5 months ago, and for an opossum, that's like a sixth of their entire lifespan, because they only live about 3 years. Okay, Rocky, here we go, baby girl. I know, you're probably really scared. Okay. Hey! How are you doing, girl? I know, you're probably really scared. It's okay. Remember me? Now, honestly, guys, she is really skinny. And she's not much bigger than when I last saw her 5 months ago, which it makes me think that she's not getting enough nutrients out here or something. So, right now, what I want to do is just kind of fatten her up. I'm just gonna try to pick her up really, really gently. Now she's not acting too crazy, so that's good and makes me think she does remember us, but she's holding on tight. Hey, baby girl, don't bite me. She's holding on for dear life. I know. I'm just kidding, I have no idea how you feel. Come here, let go. There we go. Oh my goodness. There she is. She's really stinky and she's really tense right now. She is stressed out. She's not trying to bite me at all, ooh, but she may try to run. Yeah, she's actually gonna try to run. Don't wanna, ooh. Wow, yeah, she's really going for it. Oh no, you're okay. Sorry. Wow, yeah, she really stinks. Oh man, Rocky, I'm sorry. I actually brought her some turkey. I doubt she's in a mood to eat right now, but who knows? Can you guys see? She is really not much bigger and she's pretty skinny. And that is not a good sign, because it's been 5 months. An opossum should really grow quite a bit more in 5 months. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, she's, oh wow. Ooh, wow, she's really jumpy. Oh man, oh dear. Okay. Okay. All right, we need to maybe get her into an enclosure. This is not what I remember. Oh, no. I'm sorry. This is not what I remember. I'm sorry. Okay, calm down. Rocky, shh. She is not having a good time. 5 months of being in the wild, she may never trust us again. And that's really okay. I wanna see if we can just maybe get some nutrients in her and help her out in any way we can. And then maybe I can just let her go here and start putting out food for her to come and eat as she wants to. Tomorrow is actually Thanksgiving, so I'm gonna try to give her a proper feast. And then we'll take it from there. So Rocky really stinks, but she also is infested with fleas again, just like way back when we found her, she was as well. So I decided before the Thanksgiving dinner to give her a quick bath. Wow, this really actually brings back memories. It's like deja vu. I'm just gonna put just a ever so little amount. We don't wanna overdo it with the shampoo. You're okay. You're okay. I know, you're freaking out. See how her tail is just wrapping around my arm for security there? It's pretty cool how her tail is pretty much like a fifth arm. I just think this is so crazy that we have been reunited with Rocky. And based on the way she's acting, the feelings are probably not mutual right now. But she can't fool me because last time when we first got her, she was also pretty nasty toward us. However, within 2 days, she was eating from my hand. Now look at her body. It's not the worst, but it is very skinny. She just overall looks a little malnourished. All right, Rocky, we're almost done, girl. We're almost done. I don't know if you can see, but there are like literally fleas crawling on her face. Most of them are dying. That one's still alive though, so there you go. She's gonna feel a lot of relief after this bath, and it'll also help me handle her without getting a whole bunch of fleas. Oh, there's another one. I know that was traumatic, but you're done. Oh no. Oh no, that did not work. Oh dear. Hey, baby girl, I'm sorry. Shh. Let me dry you off. So just like a few months ago when she was a little baby, we're using the cool setting on the hair dryer so it doesn't hurt her. Bam, now she's fluffy like a porcupine. Let her have some alone time so that she can finish drying here in the warm house. And so she can hopefully relax a little bit. I admit, Rocky is a lot more antisocial than she was 5 months ago. She's scared. But here's the thing, opossums sleep during the day, pretty much the whole day. They come out around like 1 a.m., at least Rocky does in my experience. So my plan is, what better way for her to get used to me than for her to sleep with me? She'll be able to get used to the human smell and my voice. I'm going to Walmart right now to find an extra large hoodie that she can sleep in the pouch of, because opossums are also marsupials, which means when they're babies, they actually live in their mom's pouch, which is really cool. And we're going to kind of bring her back to her childhood so that she can get used to me. So I wanted to actually bring Rocky on this shopping trip, but I looked into the rules for Walmart and they actually don't allow pets unless it's a service animal. And we don't have Rocky's papers for that yet. We need like a huge hoodie. Oh snap, I already know Rocky's gonna like this tie-dye. Let's see, do we have a huge one? Ooh, 2x extra large. Bam. Now the thing is, will the pocket hold Rocky? Ooh, it's gonna be a squeeze. Yo, I just had a crazy idea. What if we got like a baby pouch that moms carry babies with for Rocky? This is perfect. Look, that's what got my attention. Close enough to kiss. Okay, come on, this is what we're going for. Look at this back picture. That's practically me. I mean, even the facial hair, I have a little work to do. One size fits all so Rocky can grow. It's gray, that's Rocky's favorite color. Pretty sure this was meant to be. I just had the idea we're gonna go to the pet section, see if we can get Rocky something nice to kind of transition her into living with us. Okay, so she needs like a bed or something, but this is not it. There's a whole bunch of beds here. Rocky ain't no dog, so we're gonna make a hybrid. This is the base of the bed, and then I'm gonna get another puppy bed so she can crawl in and have a little bit of a cover. What on earth is this? This is probably completely unnecessary, but it might keep Rocky company in her bed, so. This looks like a Jeffrey. We're gonna name him Jeffrey. Oh snap. This, she's gonna love. This is like roasted chicken entree cat food. Jeffrey, what do you think? You think that's a good idea? Oh my gosh, Jeffrey, time out. You stay there. Golly. Kids, man. All right, Jeffrey, before I take you home, I need to check your temperature, okay? So So I have no idea how this is going to turn out or how it's going to work, but I'm actually really excited to see if Rocky likes it.
Let's see how this thing works.
Just looks like a giant blanket.
What on earth?
Oh no, I'm supposed to know how to do things?
Yuck. We'll figure something out.
What?
Okay, so you hold it like this, and you fold. Bingo. We're on to something, guys.
I actually don't know what to do. This cannot be that hard, okay? This is practice. This is good training for the future when I have kids. I would say the problem's because it's not in English, but it actually doesn't have any words. It's all pictures.
So number one, you hold it. Number two, you fold it. Number three, you're like a dang eagle.
I'm a dang eagle!
And four, you're ready to go.
Hold it. Step two, hold it. Dude, that's like a lot smaller than they show it. We're just doing it, okay? So now step three is over the shoulder. Then I'm pretty sure they like wrapped it underneath here and then tied it right there. We're gonna figure this out. Wait. Yeah.
What?
I'm a ribbon dancer.
Did I really just pay $50 for that?
Yo, I think I got it.
I think we figured it out, okay?
So bam,
Rocky goes in here,
we're good.
Boom. First try, no problem.
Let's see if she likes the
couch.
Aw. I don't know if she likes it. Do you like it, baby?
She's trying to bury her face in it.
Boom. Hope she doesn't bite my belly.
Her little face. Hey, Rocky. What are you doing?
She's like, I'm stuck in this pouch. What do you think I'm doing?
I'm going to just kind of walk around a little bit, see if she falls asleep. We'll see if this was a good idea to kind of get her used to me again. Because right now, as she's right next to me, she's going to hear my voice. She's going to feel my motions and my heartbeat, but she's also going to smell me. Wait a minute. I almost forgot.
Rocky, I have a new friend for you. His name's Jeffrey.
Jeffrey will also help keep you warm.
$50 well spent. I'm a proud father today. I've birthed a child.
Oh, hey, didn't see you there. So I've been carrying Rocky for quite a while. Now it's just time to put her to bed, and then tomorrow when she's rested up, Thanksgiving dinner for Rocky.
You excited, girly girl? You excited?
I think that's her way of saying she's excited. She's extremely antisocial.
Good night, Rocky. Good night. You wanna go in? There you go. It's your new bed. Go on. There you go.
Good night, pooper. Ba-dum-bum-doo-doo-doo.
Aw. Good morning, Rocky. You awake? Time for Thanksgiving dinner. Thanksgiving dinner.
Mademoiselle, today we have turkey for Thanksgiving dinner, some green beans, some stuffing, some brie cheese, a blueberry, a little piece of steak, and bacon. And in the middle we have some of your favorite Greek yogurt. Are you excited? It's a terrible accent. But in all seriousness, I'm actually excited to see which one she goes for first.
Bon appetit, monsieur. She's kind of shaking. Oh, of course she goes for the yogurt first. Oh, she loves it. You like that? Is that delicious?
Here, I'm gonna sit down here and
hear. Oh no.
Hey, look, I got it right here. I got it right here. There you go. Here, there you go. It's good, it's good. Oh, come on, food.
Oh, I think she's trying to get away.
Okay. There you go.
Oh,
Well, should go for the steak?
She loves that yogurt.
Ooh, got him. Did you see that? She ate that blueberry. That's crazy. Was that good? I didn't know you liked blueberries so much, girl. Ooh, there's the bacon. You like bacon? Maybe a little bit? Ooh, she does like... Oh, maybe not. She doesn't like that little piece of steak. Let me turn the plate. Do you like stuffing? Ooh, I know you smell it. Hey, baby, come on. You getting distracted? Children. Oh, she's climbing down my back. Look at that angle. How can she even hold on to my coat like that?
Aw,
she's getting a little nervous.
Do I still make you nervous?
You're okay.
There we go.
It's probably important to note that this food that I'm giving her for Thanksgiving dinner is not like the ideal staple possum food. But give her a break, it's Thanksgiving. A lot of it is good for her, especially like the yogurt because it has more calcium. And something about possums is they need an extra amount of calcium. So if they're in the wild and they eat a lizard, they eat the skeleton. If they find a mouse, they eat the skeleton. If they find an egg, they eat the shell because they need that calcium. Otherwise they'll get something called metabolic bone disease. And that is a miserable thing for an opossum to have. Are you done with your Thanksgiving dinner? She's like that kid at Thanksgiving dinner that takes one bite and then is like, I'm done. I'm like, do you understand? Ow! She actually just nipped me, guys. Yee, she nipped my finger a little bit. Kinda hurt. Oof, that's emotional. That's the first time Rocky has ever nipped me, ever. I gotta be more careful because I was just reaching back and I wasn't looking where I was reaching. Hey, baby girl, I forgive you for biting me, but we need to talk.
You should show your finger.
I don't know, it's kinda bloody. Okay, guys, so it's actually bleeding a little bit. Oh, she's getting away. Oh no, oh no. You're okay. Come here. Guys, by the way, it's important to remember, it's important to note that she is very skinny and a bit malnourished. Okay, I don't want her to bite me again, so I'm literally, okay. Okay, oh no, okay. She's malnourished, and so I want to fatten her up a bit, but eventually I want to let her go here and just have her know that she can come to me, or at least my yard, for food. And that way, she can survive better in this neighborhood, because honestly, the 5 months she was on her own in this neighborhood, obviously she did not grow very well, and she's pretty skinny. So my ultimate goal, I don't know how the plan's gonna pan out, but my ultimate goal is to get her nourished, get her fattened up a little bit, and then let her go here again with her having the knowledge that she can come and get the proper nutrients here. This is probably pretty stupid, but I kind of want like a thumbnail shot of her sitting on my head, because I did that when she was a little baby before, flashback right now. I think it's pretty cool. I want to see if she can sit on my head again without freaking her out too much. Posing for the thumbnail. Is this good, guys? Does this get your attention? Is this why you clicked on the video? All right, guys. Okay. Okay, my finger's bloody. Gonna wash it out thoroughly. Thankfully, possums don't carry near as many diseases because of their fascinating complex of a low body temperature. So it's pretty much impossible for them to carry things like rabies because it just can't survive that body temperature. She's cold. I'm gonna get her inside. We're gonna see if she wants to eat the rest of her dinner, but on her own.